Hello friends, welcome. We will be dealing with the experiments related to operational amplifiers and linear integrated circuits. We will start with the experiment of operational amplifier applications. In that, today we will be discussing about the adder circuit. As we know, the IC741 is a 8-bit IC. Out of that, the pin number 2 and 3 are inputs. 6 is an output, and 7 and pin number 4 are used to apply the bias voltages. The pin number 2 is marked with a negative sign and we call it as inverting terminal. Pin number 3 is assigned a positive sign and it is a non-inverting terminal. Now the adder circuit can be designed both in non-inverting mode, or you can call it as a differential amplifier mode, or in an inverting mode. The figure shows an inverting mode adder circuit which is designed to give gain is equal to 1. We can see in the circuit that the non-inverting terminal, that is pin number 3, is grounded directly, and the inputs, the various inputs, namely V1 and V2 in this case, are applied to pin number 2, that is the inverting terminal. And as usual, the RF stands for the feedback resistor connected between pin number 2 to pin number 6. Not necessarily the gain should be 1, but we can modify it by choosing proper resistors for feedback as well as the input resistors. For example, if the gain is needed as 10, then we will be choosing the RF value 10 times than that of the input resistors. We'll just go through how exactly this summer circuit operates. Say, through resistor R1, current I1 flows, and through resistor R2, current I2 flows. And both the currents are added and those are flown through RF to the output. That is nothing but, so V0 will be equal to the addition of two currents, I1 and I2, and multiplied by the resistance, that is nothing but a RF. And I'll assign a negative sign here, and this is because the inputs are connected to inverting terminal. Hence, I'm calling it as a inverting mode adder circuit. Now, what is I1, what is I2? If I substitute here, IN will be nearly equal to V1 by R1. Similarly, I2 is V2 by R2 times RF. Say, I'll choose value of R1 and R2 of same value. Then V0 will be equal to minus of RF divided by, I'll take the R1 common, and the remaining thing is V1 plus V2. And we know the RF by R1 is nothing but AV. So V0 is gain times the addition of both the inputs connected at the inverting terminal. Now we'll connect this circuit on the breadboard and we'll check for the outputs. This is the breadboard connection. I'll just show you how this is connected. We have used a IC741, that is nothing but an op amp, which has 8 pins. So this side it is a notch, and from bottom of that notch we'll start counting the pins. So this is pin number 1, 2, 3, 4. On the opposite side it is 5, 6, 7 and 8. And as in the circuit diagram, we are connecting two inputs. So I have used two DC voltage sources. We can call it as a RPS. You can see the RPS is connected to one resistor. Other RPS is connected to the second resistor. And both the resistors are connected to the pin number 2. You can see this black wire, this is connected to pin number 3 to directly ground. Now the other connections are, at pin number 4 we need to connect a minus VCC, that is nothing but a minus of 12 volt. For that we are using a dual power supply. From minus of this, a red wire is connected to pin number 4. Similarly, plus 12 is connected to pin number 7, the black wire, and the common wire is connected to the ground of the breadboard. And as I told, pin number 3 is connected to ground. This and the dual power supply ground, both are connected in the same line. Similarly, the other ends of the power supplies, regulated power supplies, the negative terminal is connected to ground, and the other power supply negative is connected to ground. And now we are connecting an wire at pin number 6, and that wire we are connecting to digital multimeter, which will show us the reading. As we change the input value, the output value, that is nothing but the addition of two voltages, will be our result. Now in our design we have kept the gain is equal to 1, so simply it is the addition of two input voltage with a negative sign, that is because of inverting terminal of the op amp. Okay, now let me turn on the power supply. I'll turn on the first regulated power supply, second one. So at start I can see the voltage in the top RPS is nearly 1 volt, and in the other RPS it is 2 volt. So our output should be nearly 3 volt, and we can see on the output, that is on the digital multimeter, the voltage is minus 2.9. As I told, minus is because of inverting terminal of the op amp. Now let us change the input and verify what is the output for the other inputs. So let us make this voltage around 2.3 or 2.4 volt, and the below one will keep it, say it is adjusted to 4.1, make it 4.2. Now the output should be nearly equal to 2.3 plus 4.2, around 6.5, and when we check for the output, we are getting it as minus 6.4. So our designer circuit is correct, it is working correctly as per our aim. With this we can conclude that the op amp can be used to add two different voltages. Thank you.